born in Tuscaloosa. Boxing out of Birmingham. Deontay Wilder announced himself to the world exactly 1 year ago. Becoming the first ever heavyweight champion raised in the heart of Dixie.
I'm proud to say that I'm a world champion. And guess what? He's from Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
Now the Southern Star looks to shine up north in Brooklyn's first heavyweight title fights in more than a century. But his opponent is also in search of a first. A win would make Archer Spielka the first Polish heavyweight champion ever.
Good shot, good shot.
One, two, three, four.
That's it, Spielka, that's it. Right there, boom, there you go.
Gonna kick your ass.
An overseas underdog with everything to prove. Versus the pride of Alabama.
They got this country boy going to New York City. You in trouble now?
They meet on a night of firsts, on the first fight night of our 30th anniversary of Showtime Championship Boxing.
Tonight, our location, the Big Apple, with the spotlight focused solely on the heavyweight division. Welcome to Brooklyn, New York, where it's been over 100 years since this borough has hosted a heavyweight championship fight. Well, tonight, all of that comes to an end with not one, but two heavyweight world title fights here on Showtime Championship Boxing. Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Custer. Welcome to the 30th year of Showtime Championship Boxing. We're very excited about beginning our new year here at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, which has quickly become a regular host for world title fights. The heavyweight division has become a lot more compelling over the past year. Huge fights, new champions. Deontay Wilder became the WBC heavyweight champion nearly a year ago from today. Tonight, he defends that crown for the third time. The man trying to dethrone him, Poland's Artur Spielka. Plus, we'll begin the night with the IBF heavyweight belt on the line as Charles Martin fights Vyacheslav Glazkov for the vacant title. Two heavyweight championship fights coming up with the big men of the sport. So, when you have an event this big, you need a really big team. And we've got one here. You like that Drake reference,
huh? I love it, baby.
Mauro Ranallo, Al Bernstein, and one of Brooklyn's favorite sons, Paulie Malignaggi. You know, guys, last time there was a heavyweight title fight here in Brooklyn, 115 years ago, Jim Jeffries knocked out Jim Corbett in the 23rd round. It's been a long time coming, and Al, it's also been a long time coming since we've seen some excitement in the heavyweight division. Tyson Fury recently beat Vladimir Klitschko. The heavyweight division had been dormant for so long, but now all of a sudden it's got interesting and become wide open.
Yeah, it has. By the way, I was not at the Corbett Jeffries fight.
You pointed that out.
I want to point that out. Now, you remember the movie Shrek?
I do.
Okay. Remember how Shrek finally convinced Donkey that ogres, like onions, have layers? Well, who knew? The heavyweight division has layers. Okay, so one layer we know has Fury and Wilder, two big men with big personalities, and Vladimir Klitschko trying to win his title back. Then just underneath that, we've got Martin and Glazkov, who we see fighting here tonight, and Alexander Povetkin. And there are the three young guns in the heavyweight division, Luis Ortiz, Anthony Joshua, and Joseph Parker, who are champions in waiting, to be sure. And if that's not enough, David Haye won today, and he's trying to get back in the mix. Now, what does all that mean for the heavyweight division? It means that we have good, interesting, and we hope competitive fights still to come.
Only a Hall of Famer can get away with comparing the heavyweight division to Shrek and using the donkey reference. You know, Paulie, hey, Deontay Wilder, he has been very vocal that he wants to follow in Lennox Lewis's footsteps, become the next undisputed heavyweight champion. But first, he's got to get through Artur Spilka, who, of course, will have the crowd on his side here tonight. And Spilka wants to make history himself here tonight. So why don't you break down the main event for us?
Well, Wilder's now been a champion for a year. He won a piece of the heavyweight title a year ago this weekend. So that honeymoon phase is sort of passing. He's had a couple of defenses, decent against decent opposition, but not really the top level. And he's upping that level of opposition little by little. He's shown a tremendous amount of ability, a great jab, terrific athletic ability. But at times, he has a tendency to sometimes lose his composure. He tends to lose his positioning. At 6'7", you really, if you can maintain your composure and really maintain that proper distance in fights, you make it very difficult for guys to beat you. Vladimir Klitschko was a master at that in his prime. And Wilder has that same kind of height if he can really retain that composure he so desperately needs. Tonight in Spilka, he's got a guy who's dangerous if he loses that composure, because Spilka is no stranger to exciting fights. He's gone up and down during his career, no stranger to the canvas. In a fight with Mike Malo he had not too long ago, it was like a yo-yo fight. Both guys were up and down, tremendously exciting. If you lose that composure with Spilka, you're giving him his only chance, because Spilka needs that excitement. Spilka needs that exchange. And if you give him that exchange, not only does he become a dangerous puncher, but he also gets the crowd involved on his side. And tonight, the crowd is very pro-Polish.
Well, if you talk to Deontay Wilder, I guess we're going to see some exchanges. He said his last two opponents have taken him rounds. He wants to get back to being exciting and knocking out opponents. We'll see if it happens here tonight. Now, Mo, we're also going to begin with another heavyweight title fight. How did we get here? Well, Tyson Fury had his IBF belt stripped from him when he agreed to a rematch with Vladimir Klitschko, which will take place later this year, instead of fighting his mandatory, who is Vyacheslav Glazkov. So now Glazkov and the American, Charles Martin, they get the opportunity to fight for this vacant title.
That's right. Glazkov, the Ukrainian, a 2008 Olympic bronze medalist. He owns a big advantage when it comes to high-level experience. He's gone 7 rounds or more, 9 times to only once for Martin. You could say the boxing gods have been smiling upon Glazkov. He's remained unbeaten despite 3 key bouts that many ringside observers felt his opponents deserved to win. Now, meanwhile, the undefeated American Martin is known as Prince Charles, and he's been getting the royal treatment from the IBF. He hasn't defeated anyone of note, and yet here he is vying for a vacant title. At 6'5", around 250 pounds, he has the size of a modern-day heavyweight. He's exhibited fight-ending power, and he's a southpaw to boot. What we're going to find out tonight, Brian, is if he's ready for his close-up.
Well, Glazkov was very confident in our fighter meeting. He said, listen, in my opinion, Martin doesn't have the talent to hang with me, doesn't think he's fast at all. But one key point, he also, Glazkov said, he's never faced a lefty as a professional. Martin's a lefty. Let's see if that plays out here tonight. All right, I'm going to let you guys get ready to call all the action. In the meantime, we, as always, we invite you to visit our social media sites. Now, we are constantly posting new material. Before we get to the fights, tonight we introduce our 2016 Show Street competition. Here's how you can participate by picking the winners for tonight's fights, building your own personal winning streak, and earning great prizes.
Show Streak is a hit with fight fans. It has given away thousands of prizes. Now the stakes are bigger. Go to showstreak.com and pick the winners in upcoming bouts on Showtime Boxing. Rack up wins and watch a streak grow. Take a loss and rebuild your streak from zero. The bigger the streak, the bigger the prizes. Hit 50 in a row and you're eligible for the ultimate 30th anniversary prize pack, including limited edition memorabilia from Showtime Boxing Legends, 4 tickets to a Showtime Championship Boxing event with exclusive VIP access, plus more. Go to showstreak.com to register, then pick and play to win big.
Well, tonight's championship boxing is part of Showtime's free preview weekend. If you don't have Showtime already, order now. Get original series, movies, more live boxing. Go to order showtime.com or call 1-888-SHOWTIME. All right, it is time for our first world title fight of the evening. With the call, Mauro Ranallo, Al Bernstein, and Paulie Malignaggi.
All right, BC, we are set for the vacant IBF Heavyweight Championship. It will pit the undefeated Charles Martin, looking to become just the sixth Southpaw to own a piece of the Heavyweight Championship. He faces the 21-0-1 of Vyacheslav Czar Glazkov, who, as we mentioned, was an Olympic bronze medalist for the Ukraine. Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Barclays Center here in Brooklyn, New York, we welcome you as tonight we celebrate 30 years of Showtime Championship Boxing with a World Heavyweight Championship doubleheader. And now, please welcome the boxers as they make their way to the ring for the first of our championship attractions, the IBAF Heavyweight Championship of the World. And now, making his way to the ring, here is the IBF undefeated number one contender from the Ukraine, Vyacheslav the Czar Glazkov.
One-year-old Glazkov from Ukraine now makes his home in Florida. It was back in March of last year that he defeated Steve Cunningham via contentious decision, Al, in a heavyweight title eliminator to earn the right to challenge for this Alphabet organization's championship. He has won seven fights in a row since another contentious outcome, a 10-round draw in February of 2013 against Malik Scott.
See, this is a young man who started boxing at age 10, right? Had 300 amateur fights. He is at 22 as a pro, and the fact of the matter is he's been a steady performer, but they want more than steady tonight. His team wants him to be aggressive. They think he's got to come out with fire tonight if he's going to win this fight. We'll see if he can.
Now making his way to the ring, here is the undefeated number three IBF heavyweight contender, Prince Charles Martin.
So who exactly is Prince Charles Martin? He's a 29-year-old born in St. Louis, now calling North Hollywood, California home. At the age of 17, he did a stint in jail for drug trafficking and, well, in fact, went to jail a total of three times. He said his life turned around when he joined the Mormon Church. He got his GED, then he was told about Michael King's All-American Heavyweight Program in Carson, California. 6 months later, he went for an assessment. He began his boxing career, and now, Paulie, he's 22-0-1 with 20 wins inside the distance. Had over 60 amateur fights, which for a heavyweight is not a low total. And yet, again, without really any marquee names on his resume, somehow finds himself vying for a championship tonight.
And that's the thing, that's the big question, the thing you just mentioned, Mauro, about not having a key heavyweight name on his resume. Yet he still remains undefeated and has come up slowly. The big question tonight is, Glazkov has not faced a tremendously big heavyweight. He's got the bigger resume, but nobody really the size of Charles Martin. And that could be a bit of a difference maker. Martin does have a bit of athletic ability. He has a southpaw stance. As Brian Custer said in the introduction, Glazkov has never fought a southpaw as a pro. Probably he has an amateur, but we'll see some things that can come into play.
And again, he is dedicating this fight tonight to the late Michael King, the famed producer who developed Oprah, Wheel of Fortune, Dr. Phil. He died in May of last year at the age of 66. So Martin dedicating the fight tonight to the man who gave him his boxing career. Let's go to the tail of the tape, Al.
When we look at these numbers, okay, if you just look at the numbers, Charles Martin has the edge in age. He has the edge in height. He has the edge in reach. He has the edge in everything. So you cross those off, and in every instance, he has the edge. But fights are not fought just by the numbers. Glazkov has better experience, as we've pointed out, and he is a fighter who believes he can win this. So we'll see how it goes.
Intangibles.
Yes, intangibles.
And the rules for tonight's fights, there is no standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. The referee or doctor can stop the fight. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. If an accidental foul or headbutt causes a fight to end within four rounds, it's a no decision. After four rounds, they go to the scorecards for a technical decision. Let's get the official introductions from our Hall of Fame ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you, and we welcome you to this big and historic night of boxing as Barclays Center hosts Brooklyn, New York's first heavyweight world title bouts in 116 years. Tonight's action is brought to you by DiBella Entertainment in association with Warriors Boxing and Showtime, as sponsored by Corona La Cerveza Más Fina. This bout is sanctioned by the IBF, the president and supervisor in attendance, Daryl Peoples, along with the New York State Athletic Commission, the chairman, Tom Hoover. Introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Buffalo, New York, Eric Marlinski. From Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Benoit Roussel. And from San Juan, Puerto Rico, Nelson Vazquez. Introducing our third man of the ring, the referee in charge of this bout, Earl Brown. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant IBF Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first, on my left, he is fighting out of the red corner, wearing blue trunks with white trim, fighting out of Sunny Island, Florida, by way of Lugansk, Ukraine. He weighed in at a ready 218 pounds. He is undefeated in his campaign in the ring with a record of 20 wins, no losses, one draw, with 13 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, he is making his first attempt at a world title. Here is the 2008 Super Heavyweight Olympic bronze medalist and the undefeated IBF number one contender, introducing Vyacheslav the Tsar Glazkov. And his opponent across the ring on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, this vacant championship attraction, wearing gold trunks with black trim, training in Big Bear Lake, California. He fights out of North Hollywood, California. He weighed in at 249.5 pounds. He also is undefeated with a record of 22 wins, no losses, and one draw, with 20 big wins coming by way of knockout. Also making his first attempt at a world title, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the hard-hitting and undefeated IBF number three ranked heavyweight, introducing Prince Charles Martin. Once again, our referee in charge, now to give instructions, is Earl Brown.
Glasgow. Okay, gentlemen, you've received your instructions in the dressing room. Obey my commands at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. Now, anything from here down is going to be considered low. Anything from here down is going to be considered low. Touch gloves if you want. All right, back to your corners.
So here, as we begin the 30th anniversary of Showtime Championship Boxing tonight, four heavyweights will be throwing down, looking to put each other to sleep in the city that never sleeps. Referee Earl Brown calls for the bell, and we are underway with round one.
I guess nobody wanted to touch gloves.
Charles Martin in the gold with black trunks, Glazkov in the dark blue with white.
You're probably going to see a bit of a feel-out process, being that there's a righty versus lefty, and a lot of times they've got to get acclimated to each other a little bit more than just the regular two right-handed fighters, you know?
It is highly odd to have two southpaws vying for a heavyweight championship on the same bill. Again, Martin looking to become just the sixth left-handed world champion. The first, of course, American Michael Moore back in 94.
I was just going to say, up until Michael Moore, there hadn't been a southpaw heavyweight champion. And now in this world of multiple heavyweight championships and multiple championships, we're now at six just 20 years later.
We've talked about the opposition level, and Glazkov has fought much better fighters, but we've also talked about the size difference. One thing to watch for in this first round, and as we continue, can Glazkov get in the overhand right? That's a big weapon for him.
And there are way fewer southpaws in the heavyweight division than in any other division. The first lefty to challenge for the heavyweight title was like...
Watch your feet.
Spilka coming up in the main event, a European, Carl Mildenberger, who was stopped by the great Muhammad Ali in 1966. Of course, the GOAT turns 74 tomorrow, the one-year anniversary of Deontay Wilder's heavyweight title reign. He's coming up in the main event against Artur Spilka. And there is a huge Polish contingent here at the Barclays Center.
You saw Martin use that right hook there. Cesar's Glazkov keeps moving to Martin's right, which obviously you want to do that if you're fighting a southpaw. But Martin would be well served to use that right hook, even if, just as a stoppage, moving stopper, so to speak. I don't know if I used that correctly,
yeah,
Al. You're just trying to basically keep him from moving to that direction.
Exactly. Glazkov has been able to get his jab in more, I think, earlier than he might have anticipated.
No, that's the thing with Glazkov. We talked about how he hasn't fought any southpaws as a pro, but he's had an extensive amateur career, and you tend to fight a lot of those southpaws in the amateurs.
Straight left hand down the middle scores for Martin. A getting to know you first round with 45 seconds left in the opening frame. Stiff jab from Glazkov.
Neither man throwing a lot of punches. Martin only 22. Glazkov, 30 rather for Martin, 25 for Glazkov. These are not active heavyweights, especially early in the fight.
Martin has stopped 12 straight opponents. That's a career high. Comes forward with the left hand. Puts Glazkov on his back foot momentarily.
Starting to swing a little harder is Martin there.
Starts to stick the pull cue jab. 80-inch reach for the 6'5", Prince Charles Martin.
Time!
We will go to the keys to victory, and we will start out with Charles Martin. Now, he doesn't want to throw arm punches. He has done that from time to time. We didn't see much of that in round one. Combinations, he's a very good combination puncher once he gets going, and he wants to keep that left up to avoid the right hand and the chin down. He has a habit of keeping his chin way up. As for Glazkov, do not be a statue. Sometimes he just doesn't throw punches. And when he doubles with the jab, which we saw a little bit of in the first round, it's very effective. And, of course, I mentioned the overhand right. That will be his ticket, perhaps, in this fight.
The bell in round two here at the Barclays Center, our first of two heavyweight championship fights. Glazkov has had issues with taller opponents with skill, but he also has fought the much better opposition than Martin. We'll have to see how this plays out as he attacks the body with the right hand.
You can almost feel a little bit of different demeanor from Glazkov here in round two. You know, they've harped on him to throw more punches, and he's coming out with a little more aggressive stance and attitude.
In talking to Martin, when we asked how he started boxing, as he lands a nice straight left hand down the middle, he said he never grew up wanting to become heavyweight champion of the world. In fact, he had aspirations of playing in the NBA. He also considered a military career and dabbled in mixed martial arts before turning to the sweet science at the age of 19 as Glazkov attacks the body with a right.
It's easier target to reach as the body for Glazkov being so much shorter. The straight right hand to the stomach is probably the safest punch at the moment while he's experimenting to see if he can find anything else.
Yeah, it's a good point. Neither of these men will push a hugely fast pace, or they haven't in the past. So,
like you said, Al, though, during the fighter meeting, his camp told us that Glazkov, they wanted to make him meaner. They wanted him to start more aggressively.
Yeah, they do.
And especially in a fight like this where Martin doesn't have the experience at this level, you kind of want to start bossing it early if you're Glazkov and show him that, hey, you don't belong at this level.
Yeah, precisely.
If you let him work himself into the fight, he's going to gain that confidence.
Yep.
Glazkov's biggest win came in March of 2014, winning a 12-round unanimous decision against 37-year-old former light heavyweight and cruiserweight champion Thomas Adamek. And again, Martin, well, The names he's defeated aren't even household names of their own households, guys.
Glazkov, definitely the highest level fighter he's fought. But, you know, Henry Tillman said it, and we see a little bit of it now. He said the thing about Charles Martin that impresses him, and, of course, Tillman, a former champ, Olympic champion and a great pro, he said he's calm. He stays calm, stays within himself, and that's what he likes. So this moment may not be too much for him.
Martin has been very active by today's standards. Went 4-0 last year as they exchanged body shots. His main trainer is Jamal Abdullah. Under 30 seconds left in the second. A cautious start to this heavyweight affair.
Glazkov, not only with the jab, but when he's thrown the left hook, which I think is very effective against the lefty, he has landed that punch. It's not his money punch, but I think it's something he wants to throw more of in this fight.
And it comes over that blind shoulder because it's coming from that blind side from their back, because a southpaw, you know, your right shoulder is your leader. So if your shot's coming from behind, it, sometimes they don't see it, Al. So yeah, it's a good point.
Let's go to Jim Gray, standing by with Deontay Wilder.
All right, Mauro, thank you very much. Champ, you guys got after each other pretty good at the photo op. What was the problem, and is there some bad blood?
No, it's not bad blood. Just on his behalf, I think a little nervousness. You know, this is his first rodeo here on a big stage like this, fighting for a title. I think he had more pressure going against himself than I. He had the Polish community, and then he wanted to be the first Polish heavyweight champion of the world. That's a lot of pressure on a guy that can't handle the pressure.
And in our meeting yesterday, he signed this card to us when we left, and the new. And then he signed his name, Spilka. What do you make of that? Pretty confident.
Well, you got to have confidence in this business. This is the hurt game, and I'm looking to hurt him.
What concerns you most?
Nothing. Nothing at all. I'm in shape. I'm fit. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to break this curse of 115 years. I'm here in Brooklyn, baby. Well, the place to be to do it. You know, I'm ready to go.
Best of luck. And he signed the card when I showed it to him. And still, Deontay Wilder. Deontay, we'll see you after the fight.
Thank you, Jim.
That's coming up later tonight. The second of our two heavyweight title fights here in Brooklyn as the third round begins.
Watch your feet, guys. Watch your feet.
Referee Earl Brown telling them to watch their feet, of course, with the orthodox versus southpaw fighter. Martin wants to keep that lead foot outside of Glasgow's. Martin becoming a little more aggressive, and he said he was going to display an angry heart. He said that Glazkov style would be the easiest thing he's seen. He guaranteed it wouldn't go 12 rounds, so it might be the time to start getting busy out.
Martin said, you know, nobody wants to see heavyweights go 12 rounds. They want to see knockouts. Martin's being very aggressive and trying to impose his will in this round.
Glazkov has never been knocked down.
And that's the thing about Martin, you know, with Glazkov, it's just slip over his foot. You don't want him to get that confidence, and this fight started slow, and allowed Martin to kind of work his way into it.
Neither of these two heavyweights have been down in their respective pro careers.
One thing I like to see Martin start trying, though, because Glazkov consistently tries that right hand to the stomach, and it's been a safe punch so far, because whether he lands it or not, he doesn't pay for it. I like to see Martin hold his ground, roll his right shoulder, and kind of come back with a left uppercut.
Something bothered Glazkov during that slip, because his demeanor as a fighter has changed.
Clubbing left hands by Martin. Trying to exploit his 4.5-inch reach advantage with the jab. 1.5 minutes gone in round number 3, scheduled for 12 for the vacant IBF title. And Al, you said it. He gets clipped. And I think he hurt his ankle.
Exactly. Wow. He was hurt from before.
7-8. Can you continue? Can you continue? You don't want to fight? All right, it's over.
And the fight is over. Prince Charles Martin has just become the IBF heavyweight champion. Wow. And there's a celebration from the Martin family.
See Sam Watson in the ring right away with Charles Martin. You see the bad breaks that Glasgow's had, the good breaks that Glasgow's had in his career.
Caught up with him.
It's almost weird because he got a couple of draws against some high-level fighters that maybe some people thought he didn't deserve. And then literally, no pun intended, a bad break here, he may have broken his ankle.
Whatever the injury, he hurt his right leg, whether it's knee, his ankle, and you felt it from the first slip.
Right.
You could feel he wasn't the same.
I think it was more the ankle than the punch that hurt him.
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah, you caught that, because when he got up, I didn't expect him to react in any kind of uncomfortable way, because it didn't seem anything happened. Right. But then, you know, you caught that something had changed in his body language, and clearly, as the fight ended, it was something with his ankle.
Obviously concerned, listening into the doctor. Meanwhile, a muted celebration. And again, Paulie, you're the former two-time champion. I mean, what do you take away? A win is a win, but it was an injury.
Yeah, it was an injury. I mean, you got to feel great if you're Charles Martin. You just won a piece of the heavyweight title. I don't think it's sunk in yet. I mean, this might just end it, and he's almost like, yeah, I won. But I don't even think he realizes, he's just won a piece of the heavyweight title. It's going to mean a lot of money, a lot more recognition for him. And as we talked about before, this is a guy that hadn't fought at this level. All of a sudden, now he finds himself with a piece of the heavyweight title.
And he becomes the second American to now own a piece of the heavyweight crown.
Southpaw.
Yes. Sixth Southpaw champion, Paulie.
I think the only thing that they would have probably liked, because you're always thinking of this in the game of boxing, is they would have liked it to be more definitive, because that enhances you. But you make the point, at the end of the day, you got to share the title, you got
to
win.
And Al, of course, he'll get a chance to be more definitive in his first defense, where he'll get paid a lot more money.
We'll take a look at what happened. Here's where Martin is going to throw a right hook. Well, actually, that's the beginning. That's where he, and it, and left hand. And he is in pain from, I think,
could it be his knee?
What? Yeah, knee or ankle, I don't know. We'll find out.
Because clearly he's in pain now.
Yeah, clearly he's hurt. And we'll look at yet another angle to see how this might have happened. Now, I don't know if their legs caught, but he had been down already. Well, really, boy, there's not too much there. One punch, but it's he's in pain.
And before anybody questions the character, Al, this is a guy who's clearly been tough throughout his career.
Absolutely.
This isn't a guy who questions his character. He's got character proven. There's clearly an injury, even if we're not seeing it.
I agree with you. And we'll look at the actual punch. We'll kind of get a good look at it here to see what landed. Nothing
not
landed.
Not much.
Nothing
not
landed.
Anything.
To be honest, I think the injury came from that. And let's take a look at the legs, because...
Yeah, that's what I thought here on the 4K camera.
He throws a right to the body. And their legs get tangled up. And there's his right leg, which twists in an odd kind of a way.
So it was his knee.
Yes. And I believe he had already tweaked it before.
Yep.
And
you,
whatever the case,
Paulie Malignaggi, the fastest person alive to get a medical degree.
I was just guessing once we didn't see any ankle roll on the initial replay.
Not a laughing matter, I know. And
I'll tell you what, Spilka and Wilder have to suddenly get ready quickly. They have to warm up quickly. You know, this fight started so slowly. If you're the fight right
this
after.
This is good, though. This is a good sign. He's walking off. Yeah. Under his
own. That doesn't necessarily mean it's not a tear.
No, exactly, but shows his toughness. So we will make it official now. Let's go up to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 1 minute 50 seconds in round number 3. Glazkov suffering an injury to his knee and is unable to continue. He is the winner by way of technical knockout, still undefeated, and the new IBF heavyweight champion of the world, Prince Charles Martin.
So Prince Charles Martin becomes the second current heavyweight champion, the second Southpaw champion in history, joining another American Michael Moore, the sixth joining another American Michael Moore. Let's go to Jim Gray, who's standing by with the winner.
All right, Moro, thank you very much. I just spoke to Dr. Jeff Kaplan, and he believes that it could be a torn right ACL in the knee, which has caused the stoppage of this fight. Charles, congratulations to you. An abrupt ending.
Thank you.
Yeah, yet you still win the title. It kind of mixed emotions at this moment?
Yeah, I still wanted to fight, you know. It was a 12-round fight. We trained for 12 rounds, and we were just going to get stronger as the rounds went. When they go down, we go up.
Did you notice anything that might have happened earlier in the fight that caused that knee to have the problem when it ended?
Not really. He just kind of twisted his ankle, it looked like, when I hit him, you know. I guess the force of, you know, him.
Well, he actually didn't connect on that. Yeah. He didn't connect.
No, he didn't. No, but I'm saying, just anywhere I hit, anywhere I land.
This is not force. I hit him in the body and his legs will fly out. Back of him. It's true.
Well, we can take a look at it. If we can get our guys, David Dinkins, to roll this in the truck. This is how the fight ended. And obviously, as you said, you were preparing for this fight to go the entire 12 rounds. And then the fight just abruptly ends. So what would you like to do? Apparently, we're not going to take a look at that. What would you like to do now that you have the title?
Unify it, man. I want to fight for more. I ain't got no fight. We didn't even fight. I want another fight. I want to fight.
All right. Charles, we do have it ready now here to take a look at the end. Right here. Take a look right there, Charles. Here's what happens. You just kind of graze him right here. And take a look at what happens here. Tell us what you're thinking.
Hey, it's boxing, you know. I don't know. That was a football injury. He just did some, like, he's in the football field. Sorry, I'm sorry for him. You know, I'm sorry. It's unfortunate. He couldn't finish the fight. But I'd like to thank, you know, my manager, my team, Al Heyman, my family, my mom over there. I love y'all. I love y'all.
The fans are booing, but he didn't cause the injury. The injury was a freak accident. Charles, congratulations
Michael
to you.
Michael King, rest in peace.
That's right. Rest in peace, Michael King, a man who was top supporter of yours. Congratulations, Charles, under these conditions. I know you still have the championship. Good luck as the champ, and thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Mauro, back to you.
So Prince Charles Martin is the IBF heavyweight champion. Right now, a closer look at the only four-time heavyweight champion in history. Evander Holyfield made a record 18 appearances here on Showtime. We watched his remarkable career develop and grow from a U.S. Olympian to a boxing legend.
When other people fight now, you kind of think about when the whole show was you.
It's showtime.
You're like this, and all the lights just light up. It felt so good.
I still love it.
All my best fights have been on Showtime. Not Ricky Parker out, beat Buster Douglas, beat Mike Tyson again.
Yep.
Proud as I could be.
And we'll have more on the real deal of Evander Holyfield and his remarkable career with Brian Custer later in our telecast. Right now, an apology to Dr. Pauly Malignaggi, as it appears it was a knee injury. Al, as we revisit what just went down, a strange start to the 30th anniversary of Showtime Championship Boxing.
Yeah, Pauly got his medical degree from the University of Brooklyn. Before there was the final stoppage, there was a slip. And here's where He got his leg got caught and he fell down. And I believe, even though it was the left leg that got hurt, I think it tweaked
his...
His
weight was on his right leg, though. Exactly. He pulls back, and his weight was on his right leg in a weird position.
And when he gets up, look, he's limping a little bit.
Yeah, he put his weight on the back, on his right leg.
And his demeanor changed, and then later, this is where the right knee apparently really got in trouble, Paulie.
Yep, and again, he's pulling back. You see, he's pushing his weight from his left foot back on his right leg again. And clearly, the right leg is already injured from the initial slip.
Precisely.
And the right leg could not hold the weight up again.
And that's the story.
So Prince Charles Martin is undefeated now at 23-0-1, 21 wins inside the distance. We talked about the boxing god smiling upon Tsar Glazkov. They weren't smiling on him tonight as he suffers an injury and goes down to defeat for the first time. All right, so while the fight didn't last long, there was a lot going on in the corner.
Let your hands go now. Stop pinpacking with this guy, one punch for one punch. All right? Make this joker realize it, but you gotta come from his chest up. All right? Don't worry about trying to keep hitting at the head. Aim at his chest and you'll hit this cat, bro. Believe it, bro. Now keep him from going to that side.
I'm just getting warmed up. We got 12 rounds.
Yeah. You're the heavyweight champion of the world.
Heavyweight.
So an ecstatic corner, Prince Charles Martin. No one expected him to be here, but Brian Custer, he will walk out of Brooklyn a heavyweight champion.
Yeah, you're right about that, Mo. You know, I go back to what Charles Martin told us in our fighter meeting. He said, listen, people may not know me then, but they're going to know me now. Hey, he's right. He's got a piece of the heavyweight title. And, you know, it's a bad break for Czar Glazkov. The irony is he thought this would be an easier route for him to get a piece of the heavyweight title as opposed to fighting Deontay Wilder, which many thought was going to happen at the end of December. He takes this route, and then look at what happens to him. All right, still to come, our main event, the WBC heavyweight champ, Deontay Wilder, taking on Artur Spilka. Now, we hope you're enjoying this Showtime free preview weekend. Here's more on how to keep the great programs coming your way.
Free preview ends Monday. Order Showtime now.
All right, here's what's coming up from Showtime Sports. Inside the NFL has new episodes every Tuesday at 9 p.m. You can join Adam Schein, Phil Sims, Boomer Esiason, and Brandon Marshall as they guide you through the playoff season all the way up to and following Super Bowl 50. Showbox, the new generation. It returns for 2016 on Friday, January 22nd. The main event features undefeated middleweight Rob Brandt against DeCarlo Perez. And there's more Showbox on Friday, February 19th. Two undefeated super bantamweights in action as Adam Lopez takes on Mario Munoz. Saturday, February 27th, Showtime will present a special day of boxing. First up, Showtime Boxing International with a super bantamweight unification title fight. IBF champion Carl Frampton takes on WBA titleist Scott Quigg with live coverage from Manchester, England. Then later that same day on Showtime Championship Boxing, undefeated WBA featherweight champ Leo Santa Cruz defends his title against former world champion Kiko Martinez from the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. Well, 2016 marks 30 years of Showtime Championship Boxing. Now, all year long, we'll commemorate legendary boxers, compelling rivalries, and great fights that have been part of our remarkable history. Tonight, we shine the spotlight on former cruiserweight and heavyweight world champion Evander Holyfield. Holyfield fought a record 18 times here on Showtime, from unifying the cruiserweight title to winning some of his biggest heavyweight title fights. It was on Showtime that Holyfield established himself as the fighter of the decade in the 90s. In the ring, highly entertaining, consistently successful, and without question, the real deal.
I had told people a long time ago, only one person I was afraid of, my mama. That's it. The only reason why I'm afraid of my mama because I couldn't hit her back. Everybody else, I knew I could. So undisputed, undefeated cruiserweight champion. The cruiserweight division gave me the opportunity to grow into the heavyweight that I really wanted to be. This fight with Buster Douglas, it was like a dream come true. Once I got in the ring, he getting ready to blow me up that right. That's what he caught Tyson with. He shot it up. I hit him right on the chin, and it was enough. It's amazing. People say, oh, you beat Buster Douglas, but you ain't beat Mike Tyson. It's like you just holding the belt for Mike. Then Mike belts. My mama told me, she said, son, you know what? You can't wish good fighters away. They don't go nowhere. I realized that eventually I was gonna fight Mike. I set his tapes and all his fight, he always going forward. Like, you know, that cat chasing that mouse. The cat always good when it comes forward. The cat don't do nothing when they have to go backwards. In the 10th round, I called him.
Tyson's in trouble. Holyfield's unloading and taking a shot.
But the bell saved him. I realized I got to get him out away from the corner. I got to bait him to come out and try to reach for me. He extend that arm out, and I catch him with a shot. And finally, I said, oh, this is how it feels to be the heavyweight champion of the world. Because you know what? The world say, you're right. You're the man.
The waiting is over. The rematch is here.
Going into the second fight, he started trying to box me, and I was kind of, what? No, he's not. I was hitting him with some of the hardest shots that I can ever remember. I was hitting him solid. I thought I was going to knock him out, but I didn't know he was going to get disqualified.
Oh, my goodness. Holyfield bit by a dirty Mike Tyson.
I can't believe what I'm seeing.
He's got a bloody right ear.
When he bit my ear, man, it hurt so bad. When he bit me the second time, he let me know that I really want to get out of this fight. Only reason why I didn't bite Mike Tyson back, what my grandmama said, they always gonna catch the second person, and you're gonna get it worse. I was able to not do anything, just forgive Mike, and it's pretty much changed my life. I only got in boxing because I was good in boxing. I played football, I played all these different sports, but I wasn't the best. My mama said, find something you can be the best. 20 years later, I become the heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, for more on Evander Holyfield and his great fights, check out Showtime, Showtime On Demand, Showtime Anytime, and Showtime's new online streaming service. Now, in the upcoming months, we'll feature fighters, rivalries, other memorable moments as Showtime celebrates 30 years of championship boxing. And we've got our main event. It is straight ahead, the WBC Heavyweight Championship, Deontay Wilder taking on Artur Spilka. And speaking of great heavyweight champions, our Jim Gray, he's standing by with two of them.
Thanks so much, Brian. Indeed, I am the great Lennox Lewis and Mike Tyson. Mike, tonight we celebrate 30 years of Showtime Championship Boxing. And in my opinion, you were the most important person in the history of Showtime Championship Boxing. As we reflect and look back, what stands out and what do you remember most about your time here?
Well, you guys gave me a lot of money and stuff. I had to work for it, of course. But it was just innovative at the time. We left HBO and we went to the competitor, and it was the right time to do it because HBO was monopolizing everything, especially on paid on cable television. And once I left HBO and went to Showtime, we neutralized them immensely. Yes, immensely. It was really a magnificent move at the time, from a business perspective, that is.
And you did make a ton of money, Mike.
I made over $100 million while I was in prison. I had the money while I was in prison before I even had a fight. It was amazing. No one could ever believe that.
Mike, as we now look forward to Deontay Wilder as the heavyweight champion, what are your thoughts on him and what you've seen? He's 35-0 with 34 knockouts. Are you impressed with what you've seen so far with him?
Hey, let me just tell you that he's improved. And if you want to continue to allow him to prove, he should fight more fighters, fight often, and he's improved. Well, he had aptitude, which I saw, but still, I don't know who the guy he's fighting.
Spilky, you don't know anything about him?
Spilky? I have no idea who he is, and I might get surprised because
he's from Poland.
Well, Polish fighters are real tough, but the fight I just saw, I don't know. This is really interesting. Boxing has to come back. We need somebody in there to come back.
Hard to believe. Charles Martin is a heavyweight champion. Let's bring in Lennox and ask you. Mike Tyson just said that Deontay needs to improve. What do you see in him, and where do you feel he might have to improve?
You know, I look at it like this. You know, a lot of questions are always asked of boxers, and we're still asking questions of Dante, and we have to also remember that, you know, he's a late starter as well, so he doesn't have as much amateur experience as the last generation of boxers, the three kings, you know, Lennox Lewis, Mike Tyson, Holyfield. You know, we had extensive amateur careers. We took our training very seriously, and we all had different styles that, you know, if one of the styles was slipping, the other style would be able to conquer. So we had to stay at the top of our game.
What do you make of the heavyweights today? Do you see with Deontay Wilder and now Martin, even though the circumstance was such with that fight, do you see possibly now Americans jumping back into this thing and maybe a renaissance of Americans at the heavyweight division?
Of course, there's definitely a good heavyweight crop. Dante is doing the right things right now. He's staying out of arm's length of everybody. And he's winning fights, and he's got a great trainer. But like I said, you know, he's a late starter. There's a lot of improvement. I have to agree with Mike. There's a lot of improvement to make, but he's making the improvement. And we're seeing them each fight. Each fight, we're seeing improvement.
Would you have any trouble with a guy like Deontay Wilder, his height?
Listen, this is where it comes down to, and Lennox will understand, he's not experienced enough. You know, you look at some guys that came in late in life. I'm like, buddy, these guys were tough. They had great aptitude, but when it came down to getting in the dirt and getting grimy, they didn't have the experience. They fold when they got really, really greasy in there.
Mike, great to see you on our 30th anniversary. Lennox, thank you for your time as we go back upstairs to Brian Custer.
All right, Jim, thank you. Always great seeing the former heavyweight champion.